Hello, Power BI community. This is the December edition of the Power BI Monthly Update. I am Savine Reddy, Director of Community and Learning for Microsoft Fabric. You were probably expecting Ryan. He's just taking some time off. He will be back early in 2024. Now remember, I am covering just the highlights. So for more information on the topics I'm talking about, check out the update blog. The link is in the video description. Now let's get started. First, reporting. We improved on-object interaction. These improvements are in preview, and there are many new formatting options for column charts and bar charts. And data labels have gotten some additional customization options. Amanda will demo all these features.
With each month, we've been introducing new ways to customize the on-object experience, giving users more flexibility to work the way you prefer. Now with this month, we're introducing a new default setup that feels closer to the previous classic look. So the next time you open up Power BI with on-object on, you'll now have a choice. If you like how your current experience is configured, and you've already set up on-object to work best for you, just pick the left option, Keep Setup, and everything will stay as you have it. However, if you prefer to have Power BI automatically configure all the settings for you to best mimic the classic layout, pick the right update option. Once I've selected that, you'll see a few changes happened. First, the build UX is automatically showing as a pane on the right. You'll also see that the suggested type is turned off automatically and you see all of the visuals by default. You'll also notice that both the build and data pane are automatically open by default. And the format pane is also available by default through the pane switcher. This provides easy access, and you'll also see that if I select the format pane, it automatically shows side by side with the other two panes, instead of swapping in place as before. Lastly, you'll see that we've also updated the default option in the top right of the pane to be collapse instead of close, meaning that the panes that you've opened and then later collapse are still easily accessible through the pane switcher. Of course, if you do want to fully close a pane, you will still have that option through the triple dot menu. After seeing the new experience, you'll also see that you have this banner where you can decide, you know, if this experience didn't meet your needs, you can always revert it. Or if it's really close, but you just want to customize it just a little bit, you can use the customize option. This opens up the Customize Pane Switcher experience, which lets you pick out which panes are shown in the pane switcher by default. You can also easily jump in using the gear icon to the Options dialog to configure any of the other settings further. We've also made a few other updates to OnObject this month. If you are using the Build Flyout instead of the Build Pane, we've now added the Highly Requested ability to multi-select fields. To show you, I'll just quickly move the build experience back to the flyout and switch the visual options for suggested type and minimizing the full visual list. And now, whenever I go to add a new visual and start adding data, you'll see that I now have checkboxes for each of the fields. And as I go in and check my fields, Power BI will automatically show me the best visual for whatever fields that I have added in. And I can continue to look for whatever fields I'm most interested in, pick out the best visual and fields that I want. And only once I'm done picking out my fields does the data flyout close. This should make it a lot quicker for you to be able to build out your visuals using the Build a Visual Flyout. The other improvement we've made this month is the addition of in-product education. We've made a lot of changes to where things are located with the on-object experience, so now there's 4 teaching callouts that will walk you through some of those updates. These include showing users where the drill through and tooltip page settings are, where the analytics pane settings went, how to right-click on fields to show more options for them, and how to add the data pane back if you've happened to fully close it. That's all the changes we have for OnObject this month, but you can expect to see even more changes in the coming releases as well to both improve the experience for users who are using our OnObject UX, and also provide additional customization and better default settings for our more experienced users who prefer the classic layout. This month, we're excited to share the addition of many new formatting settings for our column and bar charts. We believe that these new formatting options will improve your ability to display your data effectively and enhance your analysis and storytelling capabilities within Power BI. So for your column or bar charts, if you go to the columns or bar section of the formatting pane, you'll see that we now have this new transparency option, which allows you to apply transparency to the colors of the bars. And this pairs really nicely with our border settings, which allow you to either pick a specific color or match the color of the bars themselves and control the transparency and width of the borders. And of course, whenever you have a legend on your chart, you'll be able to apply these settings either to all of the columns at once or go in and pick a specific series and change the settings for only that one specific series. We've also updated the spacing card with even more options and renamed it to layout to reflect all of the newest additions more accurately. From here, you'll be able to choose to, instead of within a given series, instead of sorting them alphabetically, you could choose to sort them by the value instead. And then regardless of sorting by value or alphabetically, you can also choose from here to reverse the order. And if this was a stacked column chart instead, you'll see that I even have more options in this layout card as well. I can now add spacings between the values of my series. And you can see that the spacing that I'm adding here is actually, you could say, almost like eating into the values themselves, like the individual boxes of the stacked column, which means that we can leave the y-axis here visible because the overall height of the bars are being maintained. But if I rather maintain the sizing of the individual blocks of the column, I can choose to also use this series explosion option, and this will still add spacing between the series, but add it as additional padding between each of the blocks instead of kind of like eating into it, which means that now the blocks themselves are retaining their same consistent sizing, but you lose the y-axis because it no longer is an accurate representation of the values of the data because of the extra padding that's getting added. You also see that these same types of settings are supported now in our ribbon chart as well. So this includes all the settings I showed earlier, including the layout capability so that you now have that control of if you want the spacing between the series to be maintaining the overall height or maintaining the size of the individual blocks within the columns. So make sure to try out all of these new color and layout options inside of your column and bar charts, and let us know what you'd like to see added next to these chart types. Data labels are also getting more options this month. With this month's updates, you'll now be able to see and replace the default data label values and easily add additional metrics. If I go into the data label section of the format pane and open up the value card, you now see that I can actively see what field is being used in my data label, in this case, revenue one, and I can easily change that out to any other field that I want it to be. But that's not all. I can also, for example, choose to turn on this title card within my data labels, and you'll see now that the field that is being used in the legend is now showing on my data labels, which means that if I wanted to, for example, turn off the legend, I could do that. And of course, I can format the text that's being used within this title section, changing the fonts, colors, transparency, etc. And just like with the values card, I can also customize this. So if I didn't want it to actually be the series label, I could choose to just add some other data in as the title. of my data labels. And I can even add a secondary metric using this details card, which allows me to select any field that I want to use as a second value within my data labels. And again, I have all of the formatting controls that I would want for the secondary value, being able to control the colors, the fonts, the display units, things like that. So with these new options in the values, title, and detail cards for your data labels, you can now really enhance the level of data density that you are showing within your charts. You'll see these new options in your columns, bars, lines, and ribbon chart. And like always, let us know what additional features you'd like to see for data labels.
Thanks, Amanda. Those were great demos. For data connectivity, the connectivity to Fabric items such as data marts, lakehouses, warehouses, and KQL databases via the OneLake Data Hub is now generally available. For service, we have two useful improvements for paginated reports. You can now search, and you can now sort on a column. For storytelling in PowerPoint, the Power BI add-in can now automatically scan the title of your slide, and it will suggest Power BI content that might be relevant. Maya is going to give you a brief demonstration.
In this update, we added to Power BI add-in for PowerPoint a suggested content strip that will make it easier and quicker for you to add content to your slide. Now, when you add a new Power BI add-in to your slide, there is a new strip that offers you few reports from Power BI that might be relevant for your slide. The add-in reads your slide title and tries to find reports in your Power BI subscription that match the title, in addition to offering you a report that you recently viewed. In this monthly sales review presentation that I'm building, I want to add a slide for new store's sales performance. Let me just write this as a slide title, and then add Power BI add-in to the slide. You can see that there are few reports offered to me, and the first one looks promising. Therefore, I click on it. This loads a preview of the report. Here I can browse and view the available pages and select the page or the visual I wish to add to my slide. In my case, I want to add this visual. If your tenant admin allows it, you can choose to allow people from your org to access this report by keeping this checkbox checked. If you uncheck it, users who open this representation and do not have access to the report will need to request access before being able to view the content of the add-in in the presentation. Once I click the Insert button, the visual I selected is added to the slide. All of this without leaving PowerPoint at all.
Thanks, Maya. I love seeing this. And you know what else we love? Developers. First, the Power BI Custom Visuals Authentication API. This allows custom visuals to obtain AAD access tokens through single sign-on. And for those of you who work with Git, we all know resolving merge conflicts is tough. We've made things a little easier. You can now resolve conflicts directly within the Fabric workspace. And of course, we have a lot of great new visualizations. That's it for the updates. Now, each month, we pick a community member that's making a positive impact in our community. Meet Idris Shatila. He has gone above and beyond. He's been in the community since about 2022. He's a super user. He has received over 500 kudos, authored over 400 solutions, and has over 2,000 replies. Thank you so much, Idris. That's all for this month. Please visit our Power BI community forums at aka.ms/pbicommunity. That is the best place for you to get connected with others and get answers to your questions. And please tell us how we can do better. We are listening. Like, comment, and subscribe. And thanks for watching.